Alright guys, this is DocM with another Minecraft video, and today we got episode 29 of DocM77's Minecraft World Tour. And I told you we need a mob spawning ground, I told you we need to clear the caves, I did it, I started it, and yeah, this video is gonna have a lot of cuts, and without further ado, let's get right to it. Check out the first part of the caves. Later! Alright guys, so yeah, we're down in the caves here, and this is how I decided I will do it. You know, I will have cuts in the main video and go down to the caves and show you what I've been doing and what I've been up to. And I want to address one thing real quickly. Look, I mean, I've been getting so many resources, iron, gold, redstone. I didn't even pick up all the redstone, diamonds, 16 already. So yeah, I think there's no need to create an organized shaft mine and stuff. You know, while you build and create and explore, you can gather so many resources. But yeah, well, that's just my theory. The game is called Minecraft, so having an organized mine won't be the worst thing, I guess. So yeah, I think I'm gonna cut back to the main video and see you in a bit back in the caves. Alright, yeah, hope you like it. Gonna have cuts in this video. I'm gonna use MC Edit to show you the dimensions of the caves. This is the mob spawning grounds. I prepared the area here, 50 by 50, 2 blocks high. And now, back to exploring, guys. Okay, guys. Second part of the cave exploring. I found a nice pool of lava, and I think I'm gonna make some obsidian. Okay. That'll do it, and I will start gathering it, and I'll be back when I'm done with that. I mean, you know, that takes some time. Hopefully I won't lose too many because of the lava below, but yeah, when you stand close, you normally can grab up all blocks before they drop down into the lava. Oh my god, this is gonna take a while. So, let's see if I can get the first one. There you go. Okay, some more to go. I'll be back when I'm done and I find another interesting spot. So, back to the main video, guys. And we're back. Yeah, so I'm gonna start doing the mob spawning grounds here. We're gonna have a four-way mob elevator. And I'm gonna start digging out soon. It's right here. And we need to go up there. I went down 26 blocks, so whenever we stand on the ground on top there, it's safe. Mobs will spawn because we're more than 24 blocks away. So guys, back to the cave exploring. And when you come back, I will start to design the trenches and stuff. Alright then, we're back down in the caves again. So check it out. I found another nice area. I just harvested some of the obsidian, so 13 blocks more. I think that's enough. If I need more, I can easily create some. And yeah, as you can see, coal all over the place, iron, more coal, and yeah, very interesting for us. Some more diamonds. So, oh, more. 3, 4, that's 4 for sure. Cool, that was a nice place. I found a vein with like 5 or 6 before, but this was a good find as well. So I'm gonna quickly harvest the iron and maybe some of the coal, and back to the main video, guys. Alright guys, and we're back. What I've done now, I was digging out the main channels here, 4 of them, and now I'm gonna lay out the spawning pads. I'm gonna use Iso's method, make him 14 by 14, and yeah, back to the caves, guys. Alright guys, and again back in the mine and or in the cave, and as you can see, I'm always looking out for dyes as well. Lapis lazuli is pretty rare, and let's have a look at my inventory real quickly. So yeah, you can see stocks are growing, more coal, more iron, more lapis lazuli, some more redstone, picking some of them up. But yeah, redstone is always available in huge quantities. So I'm gonna make a cut back to the main video and I'm gonna continue exploring this area of the cave. Okay guys, so we're back. I got 3 14x14 spawning pads here. The rest of them is gonna be smaller. We got a 50x50 area and I'm gonna hook up more trenches now and back to the cave part. Alright, and once again down in the caves, I just came up from here around the corner and I see some torches and I think this looks familiar. And yeah, most definitely we came back to the entrance of the creeper mine, so I think I made it to a part of the caves here, and still there's the diamonds we found when we came here and found the dungeon. Oh, let's get back up. I switched to peaceful after I've did most of the exploring because I was afraid I was gonna die because my inventory is stacked, you know. I don't wanna die now. So it was how many? 2 or 3? Oh, what the hell? Look at this, guys. Diamonds galore. Some redstone. So let's chop it away. Let's see if there's more diamonds. I see 1, 2, 3 at least. 1, 2, okay. Oh, another one. And another one. Wow. That was nice, so let's have a quick look. We got 29 diamonds from that cave, guys. 29. Some lapis lazuli, a lot of coal, 3 stacks and a bit more than of iron so far, and I don't think I've made it through the whole cave. And I think I just had a good idea. I've been using the gravel trick to, you know, check out the cave, and it's really big, but it's, I think you can't really see it when I use the gravel trick. So I'm gonna try something out. And yeah, back to the main video. Alright guys, and we're back. Yeah, all the excavating for the water channels is done. I'm gonna have a slightly different design. It's not as effective as ESO's, not because the mobs are in the water channels a bit longer. But yeah, we don't need a super effective system here. We just need to spawn enough mobs for my Project X. And I think that's way enough. And yeah. One more cut back down to the caves, and see you in a second. Okay guys, I'm back. What the hell is going on? Yeah, I thought, how can I show you guys the size of the cave? And yeah, just opened up MC Edit, and we're gonna have a look. Okay, so, this is the breach, actually. Never seen it like that, so look. Okay, this is the cave system. You can see the lit up parts, it's quite confusing. This is the line for the creeper mine station. It goes down and I came all the way around and up here already and back there. Yeah, but the cave goes on here for a bit. And small caves all over the place and a bigger one here. And some areas up here as well, so quite some caves to light out. Pooh, this is gonna be a lot of work, and quickly zoom out, and now I'm gonna show you, you know, here, this is the area of the of Project X, and the mob spawning grounds will be somewhere down here, so you still see there's a lot of caves around me I need to explore. And I hope you don't mind, I've been using MC Edit now to show you, but I think it's the best way to give you a feel for the dimension of this cave. Okay, so back to the main video. And a lot of work, guys. Later! Alright guys, so I hope you like the MC Edit part to get a feel for the dimensions of the caves. And I hooked up an infinite water pool, and now it's time to start creating the water channels. But before, I need to make a lot of signs and a lot of stairs, but I got enough cobble and I got some wood with me. I think that'll do the trick for a while. And gonna quickly make me a workbench, and while I do that, let's go back to the caves, guys. Alright guys, and we're back down in the caves again, and I'm on at a point where my inventory is almost full. Okay, I can throw away this flint and maybe some of the gravel, but soon I have to return to the surface and store away some of my goodies here, and quickly gonna pick up that iron over there. And then I'm gonna go back to the surface, I guess, and try to store some of my loot. Was quite successful so far, got lots of stuff, and yeah, I'm not even halfway through this cave, I think. So, back to the main video, guys. Alright, guys, and we're back. Yeah, I needed a lot of cobblestone, but I found a good place and was not that much. I hooked up single water streams or source blocks into the corners here. It creates a nice water flow. And then I'm gonna continue the pattern with ESO's stairs sign, continuous water flow design. We're gonna have a link to that tutorial series in this video. So, back to the caves, guys. Alright, guys. Still down in the caves. Basically, right now, I'm kind of directly beneath the mob spawning grounds, or around the mob spawning grounds we're gonna create. And yeah, I'm kind of thinking, okay, I might run into some trouble because there are caves all over the place. So basically what I need to do is create a gigantic cobblestone, yeah, let's say sarcophagus for the whole thing, you know, to wall it in. And it's gonna be a nice project. And yeah, this is a huge cave system, believe me. I mean, I'm down here for quite some time, few hours now, and yeah, still need to get up to the surface. I've been, yeah, kind of neglecting the coal, only getting the iron, and I'm almost full. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, some more, and then I'm gonna go back up and store the stash back in the storage cube. So guys, back to the main video. Alright guys, and we're back. Yeah, I finished hooking up the water channels. Everything works. We got some crossings here, but yeah, you can go all the way and you always end up here in the middle towards my future destination or future area of the mob elevator. So back to the cave, guys. Alright guys, I just came up this cave here, and I ended up in the area where we're gonna have Project X, and I think there's some caves around. Yeah, I need to explore them, but it's a lucky coincidence because, yeah, basically my inventory is full and I need to go store it anyway. So cool, I'm up here. Basically, yeah, more than 2/3 are done. I'm gonna light out those caves and a smaller one somewhere around here, and then I'll be done with the lighting, I guess, and we can start doing the mob spawning grounds. Alright guys, so back to the main video. Yeah, you heard it, guys. Starting to create the mob spawning grounds. Well, we're right in the middle of it. And next thing is the mob elevator. And while I make my way back up, I really want to thank Infrared. He gave me a lot of tips for Adobe Premiere, what I'm using now to edit my videos. And I think it's a big improvement in quality with all the cuts and stuff. Give me your feedback. I hope you liked it. Next time we're gonna finish the mob elevator and see the rest of the cave exploring. So that's it for today. I'm out. Bye bye.